see the light.
I see the light. I see the Delta light.
Shining bright.
Shining bright for me.
Oh, everybody.
Everybody gather round to see the sorrow.
From the Lambda Psi chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated. 108 years ago today, our 22 illustrious founders made history and set in motion a moving train. Today, we are here to honor these incredible women who made enormous strides for our community and celebrate our opportunity to contribute to their legacy. Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated was founded on January 13, 1913, on the campus of Howard University in Washington, D.C., by 22 illustrious women. Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated is an organization of college-educated women committed to the constructive development of its members and to public service with a primary focus on the Black community. All of our programs are centered around our five-point programmatic thrust, which include economic development, educational development, international awareness and involvement, physical and mental health, and political awareness and involvement. 108 years later, we continue to celebrate and uphold the legacy of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated.
And you see her standing tall and proud. Oh, she's a Delta, D-E-L-T-A, Delta all the way.
Osceola McCarthy Adams, one of the first Black women on Broadway.
Marguerite Young Alexander, a French and Spanish correspondence secretary in Chicago.
Winona Cargill Alexander, she became the first social worker for the New York City and County Charities.
You missed the quickest way to Harlem.
Ethel Cuff Black. She became chairperson of the Collegiate Committee of the YWCA.
Bertha Pitts Campbell. On March 13, 1913, she participated in the March on Washington, the first political act of our sorority. 68 years later, she repeated this momentous walk on August 2, 1981.
Zephyr Chisholm Carter. During her years at Howard University, she played a very active role in the collegiate chapter of the NAACP. She was also a very gifted woman who was not only a singer, but an actress as well.
Edna Brown Coleman. She graduated from Howard in 1913, not only as class president, but valedictorian as well.
Jessie McGuire Dent. She enrolled in the Teachers College at Howard University and became a teacher in the Galveston School District, who won equal wages for Black teachers.
Frederica Chase Dodd. In 1926, she helped to create the graduate chapter of Delta in Dallas, which became the first Greek letter organization in the city.
Myra Davis Hemmings. She had the most assertive leadership skills and served as the first president of Alpha Chapter.
Olive C. Jones. She went on from Howard University to become a music teacher in the Washington public school system.
Jimmy Bug Middleton. She helped lobby Delta Sigma Theta to participate in the March for Woman Suffrage, and she was appointed to the Scholarship Board of New York's 22nd Congressional District in 1944.
Pauline Oberdorfer Minor. She graduated valedictorian of the Teachers College and was the president of the Teachers Club. She was also an excellent musician.
Vashti Turley Murphy. She was an avid supporter of the major political issues of the day, voting rights for women.
Naomi Sewell Richardson. She was very active in her community and civic affairs and was our last surviving founder when she died in 1993.
Mamie Reddy Rose. She received an award for her outstanding talent as a dramatic reader.
Eliza Pearl Shippen. She graduated magna cum laude with a BA from the Howard College of Arts and Sciences. She went on to receive her MA from the Teachers College of Columbia University and PhD from the University of Pennsylvania.
Florence Letcher Toms. She was chosen to present to Lady Eleanor Roosevelt before an audience.
Ethel Parr Watson. She was elected as our sorority's first vice president.
Wordy Blackwell Weaver. She published a novel entitled The Valley of the Poor. Her book focused on racism and poverty in the South.
Madree Penn White. She was the first female to be on the Howard University Journal staff as editor and was the founder and president of the Triangle Press Company in St. Louis, Missouri.
Edith Mott Young. She was an accomplished pianist and teacher at Kathleen College in Orangeburg, South Carolina.
Sounds good to me.
And service. 108 years ago today, our 22 founders set the goal and the tone to make a change in our community. We, my courageous sorors and I, are the change we want to see. Today, we commemorate our 22 for allowing us to be DST.
My peace and happiness, I'm gonna give it to Delta, all of my love, my peace and happiness. I'm gonna give it to Delta, all of my love.
Dedicate today to our 22 founders who paved the way for us to call ourselves Women of Delta. We are so thankful to be able to share the rich history of our organization and the work done by our trailblazing founders. The Lambda Psi chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority Incorporated would like to thank everyone for tuning into our presentation as we celebrate 108 years of sisterhood, scholarship, and service.